Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of Social Marketing with Eric. I'm your host today, Eric Hammond from The Orange Stack. We are diving into the topic of how to be persuasive on social media. You know, social media is a great way to connect with people, find new friends and followers, and really build your brand as a business. But there's so much more that you can do once you're able to really persuade people into trusting you and following your brand and knowing more about who you are. So as we get into being persuasive, there's 5 tips really that we're going to help you understand how to be more persuasive. So the first one is sharing reviews and testimonies. Everybody loves a good review. Everybody loves to hear how great you are from somebody else, and having that testimony is huge. That's why Amazon's big. You know, they got that star rating. You can leave reviews on almost every site now. That's what Yelp was built about, reviews and, you know, trust from people who've experienced working with your company before. So if you don't have any yet, go get some testimonies. That's huge. Post results, post feedback, post success stories. Those are huge wins. You know, if you told the story as a homeowner, what happened to the house, how it sold, maybe what happened as they worked with previous agents before you, if that happened, maybe it was a expired listing, you know, as a FSBO, how did you work with that agent, or how did you work with that homeowner to get their house sold after it'd been on the market for so long? Tell the story of your success. Tell them how you did such an amazing job at what you did, and have the client tell the story on their behalf for you. It's going to come across amazing. There's a lot of before and after type of photos on Instagram of success stories with gyms and health services and things like that. Think about how you can be the before and after experience of real estate, if that's the target market that you're in, if you're watching this video. Most of the people who watch this content are real estate agents. That's why we're making it specifically towards you. The next tip along the way is emphasizing customer numbers. You know, this really tells you how many people follow us, how many people like us, you know, building on that brand of how big you are. I was just seeing that Dropbox shared a post that they had 500 million users. That's huge. You know, that's about a 12th of the world population, 500 million users. So if you can speak to the volume of how many people that you've been able to help, how many clients that you work with, maybe you're new and you're starting out and you don't have a lot of success stories, but build on that over time. You know, I sell this many homes in this neighborhood. I'm the number one agent for this type of a specific property. Whether you're dominate the county or you dominate a neighborhood, you got to use your neighbors to, or you got to use your numbers to justify what it is that you're doing and how amazing you are, and you're going to separate yourself from the pack. So if you don't have numbers, work on having a goal to be a specific number one in something, right? So that you can brag about it later. I think that that's a goal, because people like success. They like having somebody that's done something and made it worthwhile. So know your numbers. That's a big one. Step number 3 is team up with an influencer. Now this is a huge one, and it may be hard to make it work for you. I know Chris Heller pretty well, and he's teamed up with Barbara Cochran to get a lot of publicity online. You know, if you've ever watched Shark Tank, you know who Barbara is. She's a huge mogul in the real estate industry, and there's a lot of commercials, just because I live right around the corner from Chris, that I see on TV and on different platforms of how Barbara and him have partnered together, and you can trust Chris because you know Barbara, type of a thing. So think about it that way. Who are some industry leaders that you can work with locally to help build your brand and team up to influence each other's demographic? You know, maybe you can team up with somebody who speaks to a different crowd than you normally do, and vice versa, and you guys can share your audiences. I know that Chris has to financially compensate Barbara for that type of a relationship, and there's plenty of those type of relationships that happen, but you can probably find somebody free, or maybe you trade services to make it work for both of you. But who's somebody in your neighborhood that you can work with? You know, if you're in real estate again, you have landscape people, you have home builders, you have community leaders, you have business owners. We've talked a lot about teaming up with restaurants and featuring what it is that they make and why their burgers are so amazing. Find local people who you can collab with and build your brands together and syndicate together, and it's going to help, because you're going to get a new audience that's maybe never seen you, and you're going to be able to help that business in return. So find a way to give back and find a way to connect. There's a lot of networking groups, a lot of chamber of commerce type of things where you can go meet other communities, people in the community, and be able to connect to them and find ways to build your businesses together. So that's a huge one. So go out there and find an influencer that you can partner with to get new traffic. Okay, tip number 4 is to get a verified badge on your account. So maybe you've never even seen this because it's so small, but right next to your name on your social media accounts, whether you're on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram, there's usually a little blue icon that's either a gear or a shield or a like a check mark type of thing. And it basically just means that that social media platform vetted you as a business. So they verify your number, your address, you know, who you are. For example, I can't go start a social media channel tomorrow called Apple and be verified because I'm not Apple, obviously. So they're basically just weeding out the people who are trying to be a false brand. So by you being able to get verified by the platform that you're on, you're gonna get more confidence and trust by the consumers that see you. Having that blue badge there, if you've seen it or not, it actually sets yourself apart as being a brand that's trustworthy and loyal. You used to have hundreds of thousands of followers to get that badge. They're making it a little easier to get, and they're trying to make more people vetted so that you can be, you know, the number one agent in what you are and the brand that you build. So think about that. Okay, tip number five is to highlight your customer service track record. Everybody's gonna have something that comes up with customer service, right? Either a complaint or I need a help with this, or I'm going through this challenge, how can you help me? A lot of tech companies deal with that as technology breaks down and people need to reach out and have help with that. As a real estate agent, most of the people that are gonna reach out to you are saying, hey, my home's been on the market for sale for 6 weeks. You guys haven't sold it. What are you gonna do to get it sold? Hopefully you're not getting that phone call. Or somebody stole all the flyers in my box, or my sign blew down in the wind, or somebody stole something from me, right? These are things that actually happen to real estate agents. They're real stories. So as you get calls from your clients and saying, I have a problem, I wanna work with you, how are they gonna reach out to you? I hope that they have your cell phone number and they can communicate directly with you. But the last thing you want a client or somebody you're working with to do is to go online and post on social media a bad review. So give them an outlet and a resource to be able to communicate with you when they're venting and mad. They may not always pick up the phone. They may just go straight to the review and leave something negative. So you got to be prepared for that. I think a big one is to be able to provide the messenger option on most platforms, like Facebook gives you the messenger option. If you're a big enough brand, you're getting a lot of people to communicate with you. Maybe having the messenger app is a good idea so that people can communicate with your team. They can say, hey, my sign blew over. How do I get help to get it back up? You know, whatever it is, be able to provide an outlet for them to communicate with. Going on a bigger brand, I've looked at a couple places like Uber. Uber has Uber support so that you don't go directly to the Uber page and leave all your feedback and comments so that new people see all that. They actually have a place where they pull the support part of it and have you directed to a place where you can vent, you can talk to them, you can get your problem solved outside of their normal brand so that new people don't have to see that. So that may not be needed in your industry and what you're doing, but just consider a place for your clients to communicate with and your customers to give you feedback and voice their concerns and be able to communicate with you on a needed basis. Maybe it's 10 o'clock at night and two people have been talking and they have some concerns. They don't want to call you. They're just going to go directly to social media. So be able to provide a way for you to communicate back to them. So those are kind of quick five tips. My real outcome for you on this is to know that social media is a place of trust. It's a way to get to know a brand. I think it's 81% of people make their buying decision based off the brand that it is. You know, if you're on Amazon, let's just take Amazon because I buy a lot of stuff on Amazon. If you have two options, the Chinese version or the American built, most people are going to go for the American built if prices are similar. So your brand and where it's coming from and who you are determines a lot about who's going to want to work with you. If you have ethics and standards, portray that in your brand and who you are. Make content like this to show what you do and who you are and why you do it so that people know you're different than everybody else. And that's what's gonna come across as you work with new people. So thank you for watching this video. I appreciate it. We make these videos every single week. And be sure to join us on Fridays at 10 a.m. for Facebook Friday. We try to get your questions answered and we try to help you understand how to get your business from here to there, growth, get to the next level, and we'll see you on the next show. So thanks for following Eric Hamm under the Orange Stack. Talk to you soon.